Hello, welcome to Psychology of Aging. I'm your instructor, Eloise Thomas. Let me tell you a little about the course and about myself. I began teaching at OTC in 2003 as an adjunct, and I've been full-time since 2008. I currently teach Intro to Psychology, Psychology of Personal Adjustment, and this course, Psychology of Aging. I've also taught Lifespan Development in the past. Like many students at OTC, I returned to college at age 40 to finish my associate's degree, actually at a community college much like OTC. I then moved to Springfield to earn my bachelor's and my master's, and I'm currently working on my PhD. So I understand education from the student as well as from the teacher perspective. Also, the doctorate I'm working on is an entirely online program, which has helped me understand life through the eyes of online students. I do get the anxiety of wondering if your teacher is reading your emails or how long you have to wait for your assignment to be graded. I generally respond to emails within a few hours, maybe a bit longer on the weekends. However, if you ever do not get a response within 24 hours, please feel free to email me in case I missed it. I won't be offended or I'm not going to feel like you're nagging. As far as grading, I almost always get things graded within 2 days of the due date. However, if a week has gone by and I've not graded something, please let me know. Online students also wonder sometimes whether their teacher is upset with their questions. In a seated class, I would expect you to come with your questions and I would spend time answering them. So the same applies in an online class. Many students apologize to me for bothering me when they email me. There's absolutely no need to do that. I'm your instructor and I'm happy to answer your questions. I'm happy to hear from you and respond. Now, about the course, we do hit the ground running, so I recommend you explore the course on Canvas as soon as possible. When you go to the modules, the first thing you'll see is the Canvas navigation instructions. Click on Canvas Basics, and you'll see links for many of the Canvas features. Some of you have already been using Canvas, but for some, this might be your first experience with it. Hopefully, you'll find the resources helpful. The tab says Notification Preferences. It's very important that you set them up immediately. It is up to you to know how you want to be notified about various things. For example, you can set it up so that when I post an announcement, it's emailed directly to you. That can help assure you don't miss important information about the course. After the Canvas instructions, you're going to find 8 modules. As a student, it's really important to stay up to date in your classes, and this is especially important in an online class. The first item in each module is a summary page that gives a short introduction to the module and to the objectives, a checklist with due dates, and a list of all the readings and videos for the unit. You can link to those from that page as well as from the module page itself. In each module, the required chapters from your textbook are embedded into Canvas. You simply need to click the link and it's going to take you to the table of contents at the beginning of the chapter. Each module is going to be 2 weeks long. Quizzes as well as your first discussion post will generally be due on Wednesdays. Then by Friday of each week, you need to respond to 2 students in the discussion board, and then any exams and other assignments are going to be due Saturday. If you click on your monthly calendar in Canvas, you're going to see all the due dates for all the work in this course. Now, some students like to work ahead, and that's absolutely fine in this class. Everything for the entire semester is open right now. However, I strongly suggest going through the modules in order because the information builds on itself. You likely will do better if you do not jump around from one module to another. The only exception to working ahead is discussion boards. You can post your own original response to any of my questions as early as you like. However, I prefer that you wait until Wednesday of the week the discussion is due in order to post your replies to other students. Therefore, if you post them earlier than that, 1 point will be deducted for each early response. I do that because if students post them early, the same students, who are the early ones, tend to discuss among themselves and do not read posts from others in the class. However, and this is important, if you know you're going to be unavailable Wednesday through Friday to post, please do them early. Losing 1 point isn't that big of a deal. It's much better than not earning any. The same applies to posting your original response. It's due on Wednesday. However, if you don't get it done, go ahead and still post it on Thursday or Friday. You're simply going to lose a point for posting it late, but that's much better than not getting any points. On that note, discussions are set so that you can't read other people's discussions until you've posted yours. My discussion questions are about your personal perspective. I'm looking for how you feel about it, what you think of it. There aren't necessarily any right or wrong answers, but I want your original viewpoint before you've seen others. Finally, each week after I complete the grading for the module, I'm going to post an announcement with feedback, both about content as well as any reminders about upcoming activities. These announcements are going to include important information to help you succeed in the class. They'll be posted sometime between Saturday and Monday. Be sure to watch for them. They'll be located at the top of the homepage for the course. As I said before, let me know if you have any questions. Now, a bit about this course. You're going to learn a lot about normal development throughout adulthood. And yes, the facts, terms, and theories are important. However, one of my overall goals for this course is to help you develop a realistic view of aging. You may be surprised to learn that the majority of older adults report a high level of happiness and satisfaction with their lives. That's definitely contrary to so many of our culture's stereotypes of aging as a negative, lonely stage to be dreaded and feared. I hope that by the end of the semester, your stereotypes are challenged and that you see older adults as the unique individuals they are. On the other hand, I'm not trying to paint a perfect picture of old age. It does include a lot of challenges and losses for many. There are a great deal of adjustments to be made. However, as you're going to see through the semester, most individuals rise to the occasion and they meet these challenges well. Don't panic when you see all the items in Module 1. Many of them are really short. One of the first assignments is an extra credit option. It is an introductory phone call with me. In order to get to know you, I would like to chat with you briefly. It's your chance to tell me what you hope to gain from the class and to ask any questions. It needs to occur within the first 2 weeks of the course. However, I suggest that you email me right away so we can schedule it. Simply email me with at least 3 available times during the first 2 weeks when you would be available for a call. Include your phone number. Then I'll return your email confirming a time. The sooner you submit this, the better chance that you'll get the time you would like. This is worth 10 points, and after we have the phone conversation, I'll record them. One very important but relatively short activity in Module 1 includes signing 2 agreements. First, after reading the syllabus, you'll sign the syllabus agreement. By signing it, you simply need to type your name in the link. Next, you're going to read the OTC Academic Integrity Policy and view a short video on plagiarism. Then you'll be required to sign an Academic Honesty Agreement, simply stating you understand that material and agree to abide by it. These 2 agreements have to be signed before you can begin to earn points in the course. In fact, modules 2 through 8 aren't going to open until you have those completed. As soon as you have signed both of those, then the rest of the course will open up for you. Module 1 will include chapters 1 and 2 of the textbook. The first chapter deals with the major theories and perspectives about adult development and aging, as well as a review of how research is conducted in psychology, focusing specifically on research of adult development. Then Chapter 2 addresses the neurobiology of adult development, including how neuroimaging has revealed what goes on in the brain as we develop through adulthood and old age. They are an important foundation for the rest of the semester, so understanding these 2 chapters is going to help you with all of the other material. The rest of it will make more sense if you understand these first 2 chapters. There's a lot of content in them, but they are very, very foundational for the course. Let me ask you a question. How many of you want to get old? If your response is no, let me ask you another question. If you don't get old, what's the alternative? Yes, old age is the only alternative to dying young. I know that sounds morbid, but maybe getting old won't sound so bad when you put it in that perspective. My kids gave me a 60th birthday party last year. I had one requirement: no black, no mourning, no jokes about how awful turning 60 is. For me, it was a celebration because I've had friends and family who didn't get the privilege of turning 60. So why would I not want to celebrate it? In the final module of this course, you're going to watch videos of 2 individuals in their 80s talking about how they've aged successfully. One of the individuals was a very good friend of mine, Jane Morton. Incidentally, she died last August, 3 days after her 94th birthday. When I visited with her a few days before she died, I reminded her my students still watch her videos. She responded with a smile and a twinkle, "Then I will live on." At the beginning of the video, she says, "Being young is beautiful, but being old is comfortable. I love that statement. I look forward to getting to know each of you, and I'm excited about spending the next 16 weeks with you learning about the aging process. Goodbye.